Let's move now to the next stage, which is called Romstage. It is the next stage exited either by boot block or by first stage, depending on the vBoot enablement state. Since there is no main memory yet, it still executes from the cache's RAM. It is mainly written in C code except the entry point. The main purpose of the ROM stage is to initialize the hardware necessary for RAM training, train the main memory, and then initialize the CBMEM and prepare a handoff to postcore. The CBMEM is a coreboot memory. It's a reserved coreboot memory to hold various coreboot specific information. And the handoff to postcore is a structure that is passed to the next stage, containing some various information necessary for postcore to operate. A few years back, the memory training was so open and not so complicated. At that time, platforms used coreboot's native implementation of memorization. However, over time, the silicon vendors began to close their siliconization inside so-called binary blobs, in the fear of leaking intellectual property. These blobs are, for example, Intel firmware support package and AMD generic encapsulated software architecture called AGISA. At the beginning, AMD has been releasing the AGISA source code to coreboot, but later it began to follow Intel's trend and started to deliver it in binary form. Still, there are some microarchitectures that have fully open code, like Intel Ivy Bridge, third generation and older, AMD Family 16H Kabini, 15H Trinity, or 14H. Nowadays, x86 architecture is full of secrets and likely will never be open again.